What's up, everyone? Today, I'm going to show you how to set up a payment page like this or like this and how to connect both of these to your Stripe account so you can collect payments from your customers. You can even add these pages to your website menu and or email these payment links directly to your customer if you're invoicing them, for example. All of this with your free Stripe account and a specific software tool coming up. So the software tool that we can use to make this happen is called Simply Pay, and I'll link to it in the description so you can go there and try it out for free. This particular software is part of a payment system that I've recommended to my clients before, and based on how your company takes payments from your customers, this workflow and system may apply directly to you. So here's how it works. We're going to connect our Stripe account to Simply Pay, which is an invoicing system and a hosted payment page service. So this video assumes that you already have your Stripe merchant account set up. If you don't, just go over to stripe.com and sign up. It's free, and then you just pay per transaction. There's a percentage rate and a transaction fee associated with it. If you're invoicing your customers, you can use these payment links to email them out to your customers, or you can just attach the payment links to your website, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video. So you log in and you connect your Stripe account to Simply Pay. And then you can set up those payment pages so that your customers can receive payments and invoices from you. All payments are going to be logged in your Stripe dashboard for reference, and Simply Pay logs the invoice once it's paid and satisfied, as I'll show you in just a second. So step one is simply to go over to Simply Pay and click Get Started for Free and begin creating your account. You just go through this little setup wizard and you can create an account 100% for free. You don't need to put a credit card number in, and you can set up your account and test the service out before activating your account. So I'm just gonna log into a test account for the purpose of this video. Next, you're gonna go ahead and log into your Stripe account, and I'll show you how to connect your Stripe account to your Simply Pay dashboard. So inside of Simply Pay, you're going to come over to the Settings tab, and under the Merchant Details section, you're going to want to check the Stripe option, and then you're going to be asked to enter your Stripe secret key and your Stripe publishable key. And how you get those is coming back over to the dashboard inside of the 2017 interface. You want to come over to the API and click on it, and then you're going to grab your API publishable key. So you can click right here to reveal the live secret key. So you'll click that and you'll copy both of these. So you have a publishable and you have a secret. So you just copy the publishable key and you'll put it right here, and then you'll copy the secret key and you'll put it right here. You'll save the merchant settings and that will update. You can also customize your account by putting your name and your company name as well as a tagline right here. Then you're ready to create your first form. So you'll just hover over the Create Form button and you'll click, and the payment link and invoice template generator will come up, and your first choice is just to select whether you want an invoice template or whether you want the page template. So we're going to use the invoice template in this video, so I'll just leave this one selected and click Next. I'll simply put in what the payment's for, the dollar amount, type an invoice number in, and click Next. And I have a couple of options here. The first is to require the payer or my customer to agree to my terms and conditions first before paying, and that's optional. I can either check that or leave it blank. And if you check it, a box pops up where you can put a hyperlink in here, or you can just type text into this box and that'll show up on the payment form. You can ask them to provide a company name, a phone number, and include a company tagline under your logo. Now, this one is for you if you want it to show up on the header of the payment. And that's it. I'm ready to preview the form, so I'll just click Preview Your Form, and the page is going to load. So this is exactly what the page is going to look like. Again, this is self-hosted through Simply Pay, so I can go ahead and send this link directly out to my customer. And you'll notice, just to show you some of these features, it auto-populates the invoice number as I just typed in. The dollar amount is carried through right here, and the item and description automatically populates right here. So if my customer got this page, they'd simply click Pay Now, fill out all the information, and submit payment, and then it will return a confirmation page once the payment has been accepted. So now that this payment link is 100% ready to go, I can click back to dashboard by clicking this button, or this button will take me to the same place. So I'll come over here, hover over the embed form, and I can copy to clipboard. Then I'll just open up my Gmail browser. You'll just type your customer information in right there and type out your message. And I'll just paste my payment link right in there, make sure that it hyperlinks, and then I'm ready to click send. Once your invoice is viewed, you'll get an email notification that looks similar to this that lets you know that the payment form was opened and viewed by your customer. Then you can come back into the dashboard of Simply Pay and you can take a look at it. And once the form is paid, this little check mark will show up right here as a paid invoice. Then, of course, the last step is just to verify and double check that everything came through. And you can check that by just going to the homepage of your Stripe account and taking a look at the reporting tab so you can see if that payment was in fact received. So this is the standard invoice page template. You also have access to this hosted payment page. This one is designed to sell products and services that remain constant. This one is designed to go along with paper invoices or PDF invoices. So the purposes are a little bit different. Check the links in the description for other videos that cover each of these pages and the differences between the two. If you're new to my channel, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and share it with a friend. If you want to learn more payment workflows using Stripe and other merchant account solutions through tutorials just like this one, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any new videos when they're posted. I publish tutorial style trainings, how-to videos, and informational videos on the topics of payment processing, merchant accounts, invoicing software, and other software tools, as well as workflows that tie all of those things together. I'm Brian Manning, and I'll see you next time.